It was one of the most powerful and romantic songs of the decade. Show Me Heaven peaked at the top of the UK charts in 1990 and provided the perfect soundtrack for Tom Cruise and Nicole Kidman in Days of Thunder.
Well, now the singer behind that song is putting her powerful voice behind a new project. It's the movie that brought Tom Cruise and Nicole Kidman together.
I thought you weren't going to watch.
I lied.
Not only did Days of Thunders get our hearts racing, it also delivered one of the best movie soundtracks of the 90s. Show me heaven, cover me. The film's theme song, Show Me Heaven, became one of the most famous and romantic ballads of the decade. The song by Maria McKee topped the UK charts in 1990 and set the singer up for a career in the spotlight. I'll do more than make you smile. Come to me, child. These days, McKee has swapped the recording studio for film, spending time both behind and in front of the camera. And Maria McKee joins us now live from Los Angeles. Welcome to the show. Good to have you with us. Now, Show Me Heaven.
Thank you.
Oh, it's a pleasure. That was actually, there's quite an interesting story behind this song. And apparently you were asked to originally record something different. And then you said, no, I don't want to do it. And they gave you 24 hours to go away and write a new song. What happened?
Yeah, no, the melody was great. But the lyrics were appalling. It was something like, secret fire, take me higher, my desire, you know. And I said, I can't sing those words. Please give me a shot at writing new lyrics. And they basically said, okay, well, you have 24 hours, and if we don't approve, you're gonna have to sing Secret Fire, Take Me Higher, My Desire. So I went away. I was living in Ireland at the time, and I furiously wrote those lyrics out. And they said, oh, yeah, cool, okay, good enough, Show Me Heaven.
It has a very 90s music video, sweeping cameras, wind machines. Was it fun to make the clip?
Oh yeah, it was great. It was a really magical time in my life. I was living over in Ireland, and you know, going on Top of the Pops was a dream come true. I was very young, and it was a blast. It was a really, really great time to be, you know, to be out there singing.
Is it true that for 16 years you didn't sing the song?
You know, I didn't sing it live as much because I started out in a rock band when I was a teenager. It was a sort of a post-punk alternative country band. And then I had a solo career as a singer-songwriter. And my fans didn't really expect to hear a big sort of power ballad in the set. They wanted to hear my original album material. So I was, you know, I was very responsible to my fans at the time, and I would trot it out occasionally for like one-offs, you know, TV shows and stuff like that. But no, it wasn't really a part of my live show. And then when I performed at Gay Pride in Dublin about 6 or 7 years ago, and they asked me to sing it, and so I think that was the first time I brought it back out, and now I've been singing it ever since.
Hey,
I'm
Maria,
proud of it.
Do you Wonderful. Think that the big power ballads are missing from films and soundtracks these days?
I don't know if they're missing. I just think tastes have changed. You know, it's very much a sound of a certain era. You know, and it was great then, and it's fun for a nostalgic kick, you know, to listen to that. It takes you right back to that time, to that era.
Yeah, absolutely. It takes you back instantly, doesn't it, the 90s.
Yeah.
You are now starring and working on some independent films. What do you prefer, in front of the camera or behind the microphone?
Well, I mean, my husband and I are, you know, he's a filmmaker, and so we work together producing these small films that we make in our studio in LA. And music is very much a part of the filmmaking. The films are very music driven, and I sing sometimes actually on screen in the films. Mm. So I get to do a bit of both, and I think it would be a shame not to. However, the film that we're working on now, he's written for me. And it's a non-singing role, And so far, I haven't sung on film at all in it yet. So who knows? It might be, you know, my fans will just have to be satisfied to hear me talk.
Oh, or maybe you could go back to
how they're going to react to that.
Go back to the post-punk or country stuff, Maria. That sort of sounds like a really cool sound. Maria, thank you so much for sharing your memories with us today.
Thank you so much.
Thank
this
you.
Was great.
Thank you.
Talk to you again. Thanks, Maria.
Okay.